Hey guys, it's Beloading coming at you with part 2 of Cyberpunk 2077. The first video is already up, part 1, and let's about to get started too. Let's get it.
Hey everyone, feels great to have you back. So then, did you all hear about that Arasaka aircraft carrier docked in Night City? Called Kujira, or the Whale. Apparently, the Corp figured it wasn't safe in Japanese waters. Afraid some local fishermen might harpoon it for scientific research. But honestly, it's quite the power move. Wonder what Militech will respond with.
That's tight. Maybe Myers radio will fly a rust bucket B-17 you're in loading flying screens. Fortress over Arasaka HQ. Ooh, man. Alright, we're back. Go and go meet Jack.
9999 Trauma Team. Don't forget, you're worth it.
Oh, you can slide. First ever slide, witness.
Hey, V. Regina Jones here. If you're looking for work in Watson, give me a call.
How'd you find me? How'd you even know my name?
I know where to gather my intel. Could even call me a collector. Later, V.
V, your sweet little 45's waiting for its daddy. Purrs after every shot now.
Okay. Let's have a look.
And we broke. No money, so we buy no new goods.
Let's have a look.
We're going. Is it this one? What's TPS? Damage is weaker. Fire rate's faster, I guess. Headshot multiplier is better. Physical damage. I guess. You receive a iconic item along with a set of crafting specs.
Thanks a lot.
Base will be subdivided into three areas: industrial, scientific, and residential.
That's cool that you can control the elevator.
The Aratama Matsuri Festival is nearly upon us. To mark the event, the streets of Night City will come alive with exquisite multi-story dashi floats. The festival program will also include musical performances by biwa virtuosos and theatrical performances in the no tradition. The sponsor for the festival is the Arasaka Corporation, and in an exciting development, even Hanako Arasaka has announced her participation in the Dashi Parade. From all of us at WNS News, we wish you a safe...
contact you with approaching gigs location. These intern diaries will inform you about gigs. They're Jackie.
Man of the hour. Jeez, took you long enough. Worked up an appetite just waiting. Sit down, let me finish this. And we can drop in on Señor Vector.
Didn't figure you was the type for Asian. Would have thought you'd find it too exotic.
What do you mean? What's there not to like? Noodles? Check. Since Sirloin, check.
Damn, is everyone crashing to this corner?
Mentioned something about a surprise yesterday. Am I remembering right, or just had a brain fart?
Probably both, because you usually forget shit. But it just so happens, I think I might have bagged us a sweet-ass J-O-B.
Go on.
I mean, maybe it's not as big as that, but just that he's fronted by a little-known someone named Dexter Deshawn.
What's up, Connor?
Only the top fixer in Night fucking City. Badass black Jesus of the afterlife. 300 pounds of partly gold-plated coup.
So what's the gig? We meant to come out in one piece?
Our Lord and Savior wants to tell you everything himself, face to face. Oh, no pressure, but his whole deal, he's riding on you now, I see.
All right, let's hear what old Dex has to say. Set it up.
Dex is a real deal when it comes to fixers. Don't get me wrong, man. Don't got nothing against the Padre or Macaco.
Don't get me started on fixers. They cash a client, find the cheapest gun to do the job, then drop their corpse at a landfill.
Shit. Hit the nail on the head, V. Gracias a Dios. Estoy lleno. Brought your wheels. Gave them to my guy yesterday to smooth over the dip.
Thanks, Jack. Much appreciated.
Top-notch work Miguel did. Rides like it looks. Factory new.
We'll see about that.
So we rolling or what?
Let's feel this factory new ride.
First stop. Ripper Duck. And Holmes, easy on the gas, huh? I just ate. I was supposed to stop by Vic's anyhow. I got a date. Me and Miss D.
You don't say.
She's so sweet. Really gets me, you know? Me once Vic's done dusting your circuits. We'll hash out what Dex has cooked up for us.
Hey, V. Dr. Vector will see you now.
So a common practice cyberware installation is still a dangerous and invasive procedure which can only be performed by qualified specialists. Rip docs.
Vicky, surprise every old room. It's good to see you.
Good to see you too, Jake. Oh wow. To what do I owe the pleasure today?
Last gig. Had to jack into a client's neurosocket. Think I might have gotten spiked.
Experiencing migraines, nausea, hypersensitivity to bright lights.
One sec.
Hope. Kit and Caboodle.
All right, Kit. We'll sort you out in a flash. Besides that, how are things?
Look looking for upgrade.
Need some new kit, but tools, not toys, Vic. Time I bumped up my sights and got a grip.
Really? Now? Finally?
Vic, shit's getting real. Got a job from Dex to Sean, hitting the major leagues. Need tech that can perform.
The Dexter Deshaun? Well, that is something. But let me guess. Hasn't paid you yet.
Quit crying, Vic. I'll bring you the Eddies later, with interest. You know I will.
Last time. You hear? Chair, please. Sit down. Relax.
This man's hands is medical procedure utensils. That's crazy. Oh no, he has
Kuroshi optics.
A grip.
Best I've got, and should be about right under the circumstances. Now jack in.
Kuroshi. Whoa. Vic, nothing tops that on the market.
Sounds like it could come in handy then.
I gave you my word I'd pay you back, but this might be too rich for my blood.
We'll work something out. Right now, I'm just out to make sure you get back in one piece. Eddie's in hand. You peruse and choose while I scan. Let's see what's going on inside.
Cybernetic implants are mechanical replacements for the organic parts of your body. This can give you superhuman-like abilities, which can improve your combat compatibility and help you survive hazardous conditions. Shit, what we do first? What's ocular system? Your sight? Scan the environment better? What do hands do? Increase the chance to ricochet shots with power weapons. Directly aligns a user's optical implant to the weapon system, offering real-time data tracking. Ballistic compressor. I'll probably go with the hands for now. Oh, I got one for both of them? Oh, I guess so. Let's say 1,000 for the titanium bones.
Mark one, like I said. Decent enough scanner. Displays data on your cornea. Cherry on the top's a built-in external lens disruptor. In layman's terms, any surveillance cam will capture your face as a blur. And just remember, your body will still show up as crystal clear. This should do the trick. Talks to Kuroshi Tech, too.
I'm ready. Carve away.
Excellent. Let's do this. Lay that major league arm of yours right here. Just like that. Thanks. Now, a bit of anesthetic and I can start cutting. Feel anything?
Play by play, though? Really, Doc? Makes it sound like a dentist. Always going on and on.
Don't be mean now. Remember, I'm old. I got a shaky ganic hand. Could slip. Lights out for a minute, all
right? That's not funny. This is kind of dope as fuck.
Okay, let's test this. See the magic in action. Linking you in. might feel a little discomfort at first. Blurred vision, low contrast, glitches. How's it look? Feel all right to you?
This shit blurry, cuz.
Oh, this is fantastic, Vic.
Oh, beautiful.
Scanning people with your optical cyberware can provide you with a lot of useful information, such as how strong an enemy might be, or who is in their crew, or who type of weapon they use. As a skilled netrunner, you can see a list of quick casts which you can use against your enemy.
Time for the scanner. It might take you a few seconds to adjust, but first time's rarely the charm, with anything, really. Scanner will eventually sync with your thought processes and read your intentions.
I also injected an NCPD file search. But until they ne'er do well, you know exactly what they ne'er did well.
Database of individuals with bounties assigned to them is now available to use. You can identify these wanted persons with your scanner, since all are wanted dead or alive. The methods you can use to claim your reward are entirely up to you.
It ought to work like a charm.
Hey.
Now draw your weapon. You should see your ammo count in a brand new sight.
Shit, Victor, not bad. I don't know what to say.
Say you'll take this and remember the dosage. Two whiffs now, and another two in an hour.
What am I looking at?
A mild stim. Should boost neurotransmission in the short term and muffle some of the side effects while the implant takes.
Thanks again, Vic. You're the best. I owe you.
Go on, kid. Show 'em what you're made of. And once you hit the big leagues, don't forget where you came from.
That's how you go up in text.
Your heart chakra looks a little out of whack, babe. I can release it for you, but you'd have to watch out for negative energy fields and avoid mean reds.
V, yo, listen up. I talked to Dex while you were in with the doc. He's waiting in his ride. For you. Ain't but a hop to where he's parked. Next to Gramsci Burgers.
Okay, do my best to talk us up.
Do you truly believe that those women...
V, listen. I've got this delicate matter. That's why I called you. The number of cyber-psycho attacks in the city is on the rise. Now, that's probably not news to you, but this issue matters to me for a few reasons. There are people who say cyberpsychosis can be treated.
Right.
And I know exactly how that sounds, but I believe even an unproven therapy is still better than a bullet to the brain. If I get a tip about a possible attack, I'll give you a call. Maybe you can investigate before Max Tack hits the scene. But remember, you're not there to execute anybody. Try to incapacitate the attacker, and I'll send someone to pick him up. I hope that's all clear.
Well, we already know this.
Yo, Mr. V, a pleasure.
Dexter Deshawn in the flesh. Ample indeed.
Let's roll.
Mind if I ask you something right off the bat?
Would you rather live in pieces, Mr. Nobody, die ripe, old, and smelling slightly of urine, or go down for all times in a blaze of glory, smelling near like posies, without seeing your 30th?
It's first place or no place, Dex. Cost isn't a factor.
Classic. I'd expect nothing less from you, supple youth. respect. All right, listen close. Scanning a serious job now. Playing gargantuan compared to smashing up a scav home.
Let me hear it. What's the job?
There's this prototype tech. A biochip, to be precise. Job's to grab it. Simple.
Yeah? Guessing it belongs to a corp.
Mm-hmm. Arasaka. Surely that's no problem.
No, no problem. Just a death sentence. NC's Arasaka's turf. Nobody fucks with them here.
What can I say, Mr. V? High risk, high reward. First rule of the afterlife. Besides that, I'm no leadhead. Ain't gonna leave no trace for them to follow, cause we gonna do this clean and on the hush-hush. We understand each other.
You work this out? Got a plan?
Two things. First, a conundrum with the Maelstrom boys. Needs active resolving that. Second, a rendezvous. Simple. Client who brought us the job's anxious. She wants to parlay with one of the team.
What's the issue needs resolving with Maelstrom? Got a beef?
Slot in the shard. Got a classic tale for you. Psycho gang doing his thing 2 weeks back. Jumped a Militech convoy. Got away with the gear. Corp don't even know Maelstrom's involved. Now see, convoy was carrying the flathead, a little combat bot, a prototype. And I need me that bit of high-grade military tech. Because if we don't get that bot, we don't get no socket chip. And we sure as hell don't get no happily ever after. But don't get excited. It's a single-use toy. Now, I flat-out purchased the damn thing from Maelstrom. Problem is, I did so from a gent went by the name of Brick. I say when, because Brick was the leader. 3 days after we'd sealed our deal, his friend and gangmate, one Simon Randall, a.k.a. Royce, plain dropped his ass. Royce is in charge now, and I got no way of knowing if he aims to honor his predecessor's word. To add to this shitstorm, one Meredith Stout of Militech has developed an interest in said convoy.
Who's the prima donna?
Corpo agent, internal affairs. Been skidding around town asking after the convoy as if her life depended on finding it. The one lead she's got zip-tied in her trunk. Stick up her ass ain't growing any shorter, so she must be getting desperate. Be wise to think how you could use that. Of course, to do so, you'll need that frazzled cat's info. Sending it now.
Client, what's her thing? Why she need to meet?
Woman's name's Evelyn Parker. Vetting her wasn't easy. Put the word out I was looking for any kind of intel.
Right, and?
Some brothers from Pacifica got back to me. Told me to stop looking. End the convo. Anyway. Our little client insisted on meeting someone with skin in the game. You know, who'll be there for it all. Yours truly will be remote. T-Bug ain't no people person, and Jaggy's only good at some things. I know you know what I mean. Pretty much leaves you.
Think I got everything. Time I got to work.
Well, that's just music to my ears. I'll set up the meet with Miss Parker at Lizzie's bar. Flathead, though, is gonna be all you. Life or blaze of glory? Later now.
Performing certain actions will reward you with street cred, build your cred to make a name for yourself in the Night City and the world. Doing so will open up new opportunities.
Dexter, talk to Dex.
Yeah, Cortito's a big deal. Literally a nod, yeah?
guy certainly knows how to protect his biz. Wants to put us in a few small kinks. Prep work, I guess. Before lining us up a big job. There's this combat bot, military prototype. Maelstrom clept it. Then Dex paid to take it off their hands just before the gang goons had a switch up in management.
Right, heard about that. Royce versus Brick. Hostile takeover.
That sums it up. Dex wants us talking to Royce. Gave the deets of some Militech agent, too, but I don't know how much help she stands to be. Then there's the other thing. Gotta meet the client who put the job on the table. Evelyn Parker.
You? Well, what's Dex gonna do? Ride around in his limo, chat chicks up on the hollow?
Parker wants to meet someone on the crew. Dex gave me the nod.
He must know what he's doing. So, how you wanna play this? Maelstrom or Parker? What's first?
Parker. I think I ought to see her first. See what she's like, what she's after.
Orale. In that case, I'll hit the All Foods. Put my nose to the ground. Hasta luego.
Damn, there's so much shit. Can I fit? Ooh, I'm dead. It's... And it was back there. And 6 a.m. The fuck time is it now? It's really 2. Skip time.
Here we go. Looking a little put out.
That's dope
there,
as fuck.
Input. Interest you in a preem BD?
Sure. And I go.
Hold it. House rules first. There will be severe penalties for any unauthorized recording. No drugs, no groping.
Someone catch your eye? You do not grab them. You find them in the catalog, ask for a BD, and get yourself a box.
I really looked that green to you. Like I don't know.
Mm-hmm. Doors open.
Have fun, Input.
Welcome to Lizzie. What a sweet little face you have.
Hey.
Get you something.
So, curious. The name Lizzie's. Is that the owner?
for a long while, no. And it's none too sweet a story.
Now I'm just flat interested.
Real Lizzie ran a strip joint out of this place back in the day. Lizzie's Bar. Girls were paid right, insured, even had decent security. Good spot, all in all.
Let me guess. It didn't last?
No. Tiger Claws took care of that. Tiger beat one of Lizzie's girls real bad once. No hesitation, Lizzie blasted the guy's balls off.
Damn.
Gang came back the next day. Liz was done.
Tigers gave this place up to the Mox in the end, though, didn't they?
Sort of. The Moxes had to make a deal with them. Luckily, they kept their heads, organized quick. Big boss now is Susie Q. Design stayed up, out of respect. Biz booms to this day.
I'm looking for Evelyn Parker. You know if she's here?
He was asking.
Big tipper. Generous when I get the answers I'm looking for.
Appreciate the gesture. Truly. But afraid I don't get paid to talk. Opposite.
It's all right, Mateo. Wait. Evelyn Parker. I knew it was you as soon as you walked in.
Why not say hello sooner?
I wanted to get a good look at you first.
Why are we meeting here? Any particular reason? Actually, it doesn't seem much like your thing, this place.
I'll take that as a compliment. Come on. No place we can talk where ears won't prick up to listen. We'll be in the lounge, Mateo. Anyone asks, we're not here.
Nothing's wrong.
Why don't you tell me to do it like you?
I just told you.
Dex had a load to say about you. Called you professional, effective, and trustworthy. I hope he wasn't overselling. V?
You don't give a rat's dick what Dex thinks. We both know that.
You have trouble accepting compliments?
No. Just think flattery's beneath you. Am I wrong?
Maybe Dex is beneath you. Have you known each other long?
Just started working with him, in fact.
I've heard there are two kinds of fixers. Those with stable crews on long contracts and short leashes. Loyalty and predictability they value above all else. Then there's the other kind. Dex's kind.
Let's cut to the chase. What do you got for me?
Your target. I trust you know what it is.
Relic. Secure your soul trinket. Key tech in the program, actually. We're tangling with Arasaka, making this heist one dangerous, risky motherfucker.
Mm-hmm. Arasaka's poured billions into personality transfer technology. But me, I just want the data on this one. The chip is tucked away inside Compeki Plaza, the hotel. You ever been?
You know, just never rolled through that neighborhood.
Damn shame. The fresh they serve is sinfully good. Chef must have made a deal with the devil.
So where's this chip hiding exactly?
In a suite on the top floor. The room's occupied by Yorinobu Arasaka.
Yorinobu Arasaka? He's in town?
Don't you read the scream sheets? The media couldn't get enough of Yori coming to Night City. It was all over the headlines. Anyway, he's heir apparent to the Arasaka Empire. Saburo Arasaka's only surviving son.
What?
So Arisaka Jr.'s planning to grab the reins while in Night City?
Only a handful of people in Night City know what the Arisaka's real plans are.
Telling me you're one of them? Top dog like Yorinobu's bound to have an army on call. Hotel's probably a goddamn fortress by now, too.
Yorinobu keeps exactly no hustle around. Not one guard. Got rid of them a long time ago.
Huh. Why is that?
Surely you know what they say about Arisaka Intel. Sneeze in Night City, and a blossom drops from a cherry tree in Tokyo. Yorinobu was convinced his Arisaka security detail reported directly to his father.
Look, if you've got any spare aces up your sleeve, now's the time to show them.
Now this should make your prick perk up. Yorinobu recently swiped the chip from an Arisaka laboratory. He's made a deal with Netwatch. Aims to sell it to them. Have you spotted my ace yet, or do I need to spell things out?
Fine. So no Arisaka security on the device because Yorinobu whisked it away in secret. Now, where's he hiding it?
Likely in a specialized container. One that mimics an organic neural environment. On the outside, it looks like an ordinary briefcase.
And the case is?
You'll see for yourself soon enough. Provided we're done gossiping about the Arisakas.
Okay. What's next?
Now comes the best part. Follow me.
Got something for you. Should help you plan. Brain dance from Compeki Plaza.
How's a brain dance supposed to help? Need facts, not thrills.
Think BDs are only good for fondling virtual tits? Jacking off to
Would
in those
you
boxes?
Like anything else?
No. It can be a very useful tool. Good for
to say
analyzing
for sure,
details,
okay?
Human perception,
yeah,
even
yeah,
boosted,
yeah.
doesn't
right,
grasp.
All right, all right.
Exactly what you need.
So what's right. on the tape?
Yorinobu's suite. The glorious interior. You'll need to locate the relic yourself. Hope I grabbed enough detail to make that possible.
Hold up. Mean to say you recorded this?
Mm-hmm. BD Rec implant. Why, you object?
Supposed to be Yorinobu's pad on the tape. Means you were inside. You know each other?
How else could I get all this intel? I know him pretty well, actually.
We have an arrangement. Strictly business. Suits us both, I think.
Let's see this brain dance.
Judy'll help. She's a Mox, too. Besides, we go back, years. V, this is important. Judy's always been there for me. Always helped out. I trust her.
Mm-hmm.
But she's a Mox.
Yeah, yeah, I'll
not the
see
latest
you.
Member of your crew. Try not to
I
forget.
Know.
So, you'll be a good boy.
Right, Mom.
Tread lightly. And keep that tongue on a leash.
Relax. Believe it or not, I'm no stranger to tact. In biz or life.
Hey, there you are.
This is V. He's here for that BD role. And V, this is Judy. Best brain dance editor I know.
Enough already. Gonna make me barf.
Impressive looking setup. Need all this to process brain dances.
Mm-hmm. Analyzers, sensor, SIG amps, acoustic and emotive wave monitors, facial expression translators.
Judy.
All right. Compiled your BDF.
What do you think? Will it do?
Still pretty raw. But yeah, ought to do.
Mm-hmm. V needs to get deep inside. That's most important.
So, let's calibrate. Tune it to him. Believe me, I've dealt with worse. Should see the jig-jig street porn we gotta contend with sometimes.
So, we drop V inside. Let him look, let him rummage around, right?
How about it, V? Raw brain dance. Ever taken a dip before?
Think I can handle it. Let's just do this.
Righto. Sit down, settle in, and we'll get you going. Create your sensory profile first.
Okay. Hit me. Just promise me it won't hurt.
It won't. Not this time. Now sit still, look at me. Gonna run the analysis soft. Should feel a slight tingling.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, now let's set the optics and other sensory sigs. Look smack into these two screens. Pretend it's an eye exam.
Am I gonna have to do this calibration dance every time?
Not necessarily, but it's worth the wait. Give me 2 more minutes and you'll see exactly what BD analysis is capable of. 1 more sec. Need to get the pain receptor limiters in. Okay. All set. I need to test your profile first. Tossing in a sample BD. You can use it to get to know the editor. Now let me see. Where could we...
Can't he just use my recording? Why are we wasting time?
So we don't risk our necks? Besides, won't take a sec. Got something here. Should be perfect.
Boot it up.
Mm-hmm. Let me give you the tailored version first. Let you get your bearings. Then we'll jump into editing. Be diving in 3, 2, 1.
Plan simple. Do nothing odd. Don't get creative. You go in, snatch the cash, get out. And we sell the BD to those psycho freaks from the studio.
Got it.
And remember, everything on full blast. They'll spot us extra for a wicked adrenaline high. On you go.
Down, everybody! On the ground! I want to see you kissing the flooring! Money! Now! Or I will fucking drop you, I swear to God!
Whoa! Yeah! Hey!
Now! Before I blow your fucking head off!
Slow, deep breaths. Your cortisol and adrenaline spiked, but the soft activated your hormone blockers. Nothing happened. You're alive and well.
That flash of intense shock. I can still feel it, I remember. Fuck, that last second. You could have warned me how much it hurts to die.
Trust me, real death hurts much, much more.
Not so sure about that.
You'll be fine. Got everything set up? Let's switch over to editing mode.
I'll sever the link to the BD Roller's sensory array. You'll be able to look around freely. Whole scene's yours. Full cam control in analysis mode, so move around, zoom in and out, whatever else you come up with. Think of it as your own little sandbox. So, analysis mode, you control playback. Can even pause when you feel the need. Then you use the editor console
Plan
to
simple.
Unpause.
Do nothing
Try
odd.
It.
Don't get creative. You go in, snatch the cash, get out. And we sell the BD to those psycho freaks from the studio.
Got it.
Dream as hell, right? Well, that's not all. You can speed things up or rewind, whatever you like. Give it a try. Rewind. Roll it back to the top. All good, neat. Now try fast forwarding a bit.
Plan simple. Do nothing but the creative.
Okay. You can also reset the recording. That'll take you right back to the beginning. Try it. Now for some fun. This here's why you came in the first place. In analysis mode, you get to view and even scan details of the enviro recorded by the BD roller. Focus on the heat, the gun this gonk gets from his buddy at the beginning. Now scan it.
Plan simple. Do nothing odd. We'll agree. You go in. They'll spot an extra for a week on the night.
Okay, right here. Excellent. Let's move on. Now, heads up. In analysis mode, you can ferret out background noise and conversations if the roller got close enough. This tech records everything, every little detail, even the sights and sounds the roller was never aware of. To see the sources of the recorded sensory signals, switch to the audio layer in the editor. Go ahead and try that now. Okay, good. Now you should see several sound signatures in the store. Choose one and hone in on it.
On you go.
Ah, little shitheads!
Go restock. I'll take the register. How about you suck a bag of dicks, eh?
So, any thoughts?
Unbelievable. Seriously, like what's happening right next to me.
Yeah, it's how BD recording implants work. They pick up everything, all the elements in the background. Then an editor tweaks them, makes them pop. Keep playing with the sound, explore it a bit. We'll move on when you get bored. Sometimes you can analyze extra layers in the raw, stuff the roller's cyberware picked up.
Like what?
Ev's got Kuroshi optics that grab infrared, meaning you should be able to grab heat signatures from her recording.
Huh. Hella nice.
Scanning works on peeps, too. Walk up to the wounded chick. Try scanning her. Alright, next thing. Scroll forward to the part where our artist gets a lead injection.
God! Whoa!
See that? They shot him and he never saw it coming. But you will. Here it comes. My favorite part of the game. See the blinking thing over the entrance? Surveillance cam. Must have caught our shooter. You'll see in a sec. Cam feeds to the screen behind the clerk. Roll back to where the screen's in the kid's field of vision, then scan it. Chumba shot him. Probably planned to all along. Must have got a nice slice of cred on the black market for a BD like this. BD freaks are ready to pay a preem for a real flatline. Anyway, if you've seen enough, you can exit.
Right? It's too bad most of the BDs we do here are only good for flopping the log. Anyway, you ready to do this? Look at your wreck?
Dunno, I... Let's take a break. Still feel like that kid when... Yeah. Think I'm done.
V, there's no time. Get it together, please.
Okay. Okay. Go ahead. Just need T-Bug to link in.
Whoa, who?
Runner for my crew, security specialist. She'll tell me what to look for while we analyze. No problem, I hope.
Actually, it is a problem. Not what we agreed, Ev.
Judy, T-Bug's a professional, discreet to a fault. You can trust her.
Why? Because you say so? Please, Judy. I'd never expose you to any danger. You know that. Okay, V. Call T-Bug and we'll dive in.
Hey, V. What's happening?
Bug, listen. I got some useful footage from Compeki Plaza. It's a brain dance.
Compeki? Oh, thought as much.
Someone there with you?
Unimportant, T-Bug. Please focus. Need your help. Got no clue what I'm supposed to look for once I'm in.
All right, see if I can walk you through it. Jacking into your tech now. You've got to give me access. Opening port 1779. Secure protocol? Good, I'm going in. Should be getting my request now.
Got it. You ready?
A millisec. Okay, connection confirmed. Now some quick tip ice and we're clear. Ready to dance.
Fire her up, Judy. Evelyn, I felt her fear. Sure got it under control quick, too.
I said, no.
They'll have my head for this.
Then, you shall perish for a good cause.
But,
make yourself comfortable. I need a minute to...
Listen in on that conversation, V. Could be something important.
Finish. We shall see soon enough. My father's a tired, visionless old graybeard who thinks nothing will change and he'll live forever in his tiny frozen bubble. You will listen to this. Saburo is an adult despot.
Wow, champagne's
utterly
decent.
Removed from reality.
Taste boosted somehow?
Stuck in some fossilized vision of a world that no longer exists. Of a world that may never have existed. We have not seen eye to eye for the past 20 years. I am quite sure we want now. Noted.
Hung up. Go back to when they first start talking. Didn't get to hear the whole thing.
I need a minute to finish.
The program is still in the trial phase. We cannot take it to market as is.
We shall see soon enough.
Here in a drone, ventilation and cooling? Servers, gotta be. Fancy doodads in here need to be controlled.
Have my head for this. Then, you shall perish for a good cause.
But,
make yourself comfortable.
This project, he can certainly explain
this. Tired. Visionless old graveyard who thinks nothing will change. Live forever in his tiny frozen bubble. Existed. We have nothing eye to eye for the past 20 years.
Now. Read the documentation carefully. The relic requires specific storage conditions. Must provide them.
Relic docs gotta be around here somewhere. Look for them.
To work on that. Just one condition.
You wish to make demands of me.
me.
Only one. Focus on me. Oh, got any candy left?
Steph was pretty. Focus. Oh, got any candy left? Steph was pretty fun last time.
Bedroom. Nightstand.
I've got an idea. Be right back.
I'm here already.
Just a sec. Looking for the perfect thing.
Ah, you'll like this.
What love is.
Focus on me. Oh, got any candy left? Steph was pretty fun last night.
Until you've learned the meaning of the
manual details a special temp controlled container. Relic needs to be kept real cool.
So, chip's gotta stay in the freezer.
Yep, could damage it otherwise. Okay, switch on thermal layer detection in the editor. Should be easier to spot where your Nobu's keeping the chip. Loaded. Safety's on. Good to know, though. Once you're in there, don't forget about that iron.
Until you've lost the love you find to lose.
Warui kome. I miss this. You.
I know.
Looks like Mr. Arasaka had something to celebrate. Really think you'll find the chip in there? No way. Temp's too low. Could fluctuate. Nice try, though.
But,
make yourself comfortable. I need a minute to finish.
The program is still in the trial phase. We cannot take it to market as is.
We shall see soon enough.
Please speak with you.
Right. Grab the heat sig. Matches the spec in the docks.
Yorinobu's got the case here. Guaranteed.
Mm-hmm. We got it. Good work. Looks like we got everything we need. Quit out of the editor. Just a fancy ass fridge.
Tired. Visionless old graybeard. But he's nothing to change. And he'll be forever. Can't be stupid.
He wasn't long. Everything all right? It seemed tense. Got any left? Steps for you to hit here. So fast. Steps. Will you make it? Oh, got any candy left? Steps. Seth, get like perfect for perfect for perfect thing.
What love is until you've learned the meaning of.
Get everything you need?
Yep, that'll do. Thanks, Judy. We got it. Later, T-Bug.
Nice work today. See you soon.
I'll wipe the cache on your data. You were never here.
Put it on Ev's tab. Portable device for handling BDs. I already uploaded your calibration settings. Not as sophisticated as what we got here, but should do the trick.
And it keeps you out of harm's way. Clever.
Speaking of harm's way, know what I see looking at you? Walking, talking corpses.
We needed that recording, Judy. BD practically does our job for us.
The BD will be the death of us. Seriously.
If Arasaka finds out you have it, you're dead. I'm dead.
Judy, relax. Nobody will ever know.
Evelyn, please. No shortcuts. You go that route, City'll always win. So be careful.
Of course I will be. Besides, we'll talk in a bit. V, one sec. Let's walk.
Well, don't worry. Won't do anything to get you in trouble. But,
well,
I hope to see you again.
Depends.
On what?
Whether you come alone or with a tag along, like a net runner.
No runners. I promise. See ya. Not worried? Arasaka will flag and screen anyone who's had dealings with Yorinobu.
No, they'll have a long list then. Packed full of big names. Much bigger than mine. You tell me who they check first. hotshots and cutthroats, or a little bedroom plaything like me.
So, what now?
V, do this job for me. I mean me alone. No splitting the payout with anyone else. No middlemen. No Dex.
If I agree, there'll be hell to pay, for sure.
I know. Whatever you decide, it stays between us. I can offer 50%. Eddie's enough to do whatever the hell you like.
I'll be finished. Dex won't forgive a dirt move like this.
Dex isn't the only fixer in town. But my offer's the only one you'll ever get.
Let me think about it.
Mm-hmm. If you need me, call. I'll send you my number.
Okay.
Good luck. Now go. I need a few words with Judy.
Things looking, Mr. V.
Yeah, I said I'd come to you. I did.
4 a.m. last night. Gina and me said.
Turns out Evelyn's recording from Compeki was worth our time.
Beautiful. T-Bug already called. Said she's working her magic. And a flathead.
Nothing yet. On it now.
T-Bug says no chance of that ship without that buy. To work then, Mr. V.
Going in or staying out?
Stout here. Start by telling me how you got this number.
No more than your number. Heard you misplaced a convoy.
You shut him up! Spill what you know. Don't make me wait.
Nuh-uh. Not on the horn. Let's meet. Cut a deal.
A deal? Fine. First exit off Skyline, driving towards the NID. Storm channel under the overpass. Meet you there.